Hello, welcome to the last session of this particular chapter, that is psychology of testing. So let's start with our topic. So before we start, we need to know about this particular term, that is confirmation bias. So what is the meaning of it? So it is nothing but it is difficult to accept information that disagrees with currently held belief. So it is a normal human tendency that if he disagrees to certain thing which is not in accordance with his belief, then he will not accept that. So in our case, it is a developer. So because he is writing a software, and when someone comes and tells him that your software is not working fine, then it is very difficult for the developer to believe that. Okay. So this is nothing new. So this is a common human trait to blame the bearer of the bad news. So whoever brings the bad news, normally people blame that person. So in our case, it is a tester, because tester will go to the developer and he will tell that your software is not working fine. There is a defect in your software. So how to handle this particular situation between tester and developer? So the action point is the information about defect and failure should be communicated in a constructive way. So whenever tester finds a defect, whenever he is communicating with the developer, he has to communicate that in a constructive way. He should not criticize the developer. Instead, he should tell what is the real problem. So this is all about this particular slide. Now let's move further. So now let's try to understand the human psychology and testing. So since we have understood about the confirmation bias, now it is the responsibility of the tester to understand how the other person feels when he tells that his software is not working fine. So in order to overcome that, he has to communicate well so that it should not be like criticizing the developer. So his communication skill should be good enough. So in order to support these things, there are certain points which a tester can keep in mind. So the first point over here is start with collaboration rather than battle. How you can do that? By emphasizing the benefits of testing. So if you make sure that the developer understands that what is the benefit of testing, and then when you communicate the defect with him, you have to collaboratively tell him instead of battling with him. Okay, so this is the first point. Coming to the second point, confirm that the other person has understood what has been said and vice versa. So you have to make sure that whatever you are saying, the developer is understanding. In the similar way, when the developer says something, then you also have to understand that. And now seeing the last point, that is, communicate test result and other finding in a neutral, fact-focused way. So you should have all the documents, all the results with you, all the test scripts with you, supporting your point that why whatever you are saying is a defect. So that way you can avoid the fight between tester and developer. So that is it from this particular slide, and I will see you with my next slide. Until then, happy testing.